Hi, we are going to look at the next tool on our tour of the toolbar, and that is the Place Image tool. Now, this is a pretty simple tool. There are different ways that you can place images in Affinity. So last time we looked at using the frame tool. Let's actually get rid of our stroke here, and then clicking Replace Image, which will bring you up to your File Explorer, and you can place an image. You can manipulate it with these controls. I go much deeper into that in my video if you want to take a look at that. So another thing you can do is File, Place, pick the photo. That loads it up on our cursor, and you can see that my pointer has changed to kind of a little arrow pointing at what looks like a water puddle. And then I can just click anywhere on my screen and it will place the picture there. And then finally, we have this little shortcut button that looks a bit like Mountains and Cloud Photograph, and it's the Place Image tool. And that's our tool today. So rather than having to go through the steps of File Place, you can just click this button and automatically brings up your File Explorer. It does the same thing as File Place. It loads it up on your cursor. You click anywhere and there's your image. I'm going to expand this out and let's just get rid of these other ones. Now, one thing you'll notice in contrast to our frame tools is we don't automatically get those controls for scaling like we did with the picture frame. It doesn't give me any options of how it might scale to fit on my canvas. It just gives me the actual photo, which is 512 pixels square, and it just loads it up here. Now, if I want to scale it, I can actually click on this little tab up here that has the information about my photo. And if I wanted to change the resolution of it, I could do that. So that will cause some scaling, but of course you are adjusting the DPI here, which is going to adjust its quality. So I'm going to go back to original size here and we'll just drag it out so it's a little bit bigger on the screen for the purposes of the video. If I want to change the picture, I can go to Replace Image and replace my image. So if you want to just quickly place an image kind of as is without making a lot of adjustments to it, then the Place Image tool is a very nice quick way to do that. If you want to have more flexibility, then you'll want to use the picture frame tools, and watch that video if you haven't seen it already for more about that. But what I do want to show you is just a couple of cool things that you can do with your pictures. So one thing that we can do is we can add a stroke around it. So let's pick a color. I'm going to pick something kind of in a corresponding color and maybe a little bit darker to what's on my image. Now we're not seeing anything yet because we've got a 0.2 width stroke on it. But as I turn the stroke up, you can see that I've put a little frame around it. I can do all the kind of stroke things that I can manipulate, changing the corners and stuff, so I can change the corners to be square instead of rounded and such. So now we've got a little frame around our picture. Another cool thing though is I can add a fill to it. And watch what happens when I add a fill. I can pick a color and it is overlaying it with that color. And if I do kind of a gray color over top of it, you can see that this is a little hack to turn a colored picture into grayscale. So that's a fun little way that you can work with your images and change them up a little bit. So I hope that you found that useful and that there's a little discovery that there's more to the Place Image tool than meets the eye. You can adjust the fill and the stroke and create kind of like a down and dirty sort of filtered look over top of your photos. All right, thanks for watching.